the medical and psychiatric establishment. The results would be dramatic, but the outcome would be very different from what Lang intended. His ideas would undermine the all-controlling medical elite. But far from liberating people, what would actually emerge would be a revolutionary new system of order and control, driven by the objective power of numbers.
The space where you can meet with her, where she's not going to be frightened that you're going to put her away or that you're going to do anything to her.
Lang was now a celebrity in America and was one of the leaders of what was called the anti-psychiatry movement. Psychiatry, Lang said, was a fake science, used as a system of political control to shore up a violent, collapsing society. Its categories of madness and sanity had no reality. Madness was simply a convenient label used to lock away those who wanted to break free. Hundreds of young psychiatrists came to Lang's talks, and one of them was inspired and decided to find a way of testing whether what Lang said was true or not. Could psychiatrists in America distinguish between madness and sanity? He was called David Rosenhan, and he devised a dramatic experiment. He assembled 8 people, including himself, none of whom had ever had any psychiatric problems. Each person was then sent across the country to a specific mental hospital. At an agreed time, they all presented themselves at their hospital and told the psychiatrist on duty they were hearing a voice in their head that said the word thud. That was the only lie they should tell. Otherwise, they were to behave and respond completely normally. And then what happened?
They were all diagnosed as insane and admitted to the hospital.
All of them?
All of them.
And were any of them insane?
No. There was nobody who could have judged these people as insane. But I told friends, I told my family, I get out when I can get out. That's all. Be there for a couple of days and I get out. Nobody knew I'd be there for 2 months.
Once admitted, all 8 fake patients acted completely normally. Yet the hospitals refused to release them and diagnosed 7 as suffering from schizophrenia and 1 from bipolar disorder. They were all given powerful psychotropic drugs. They found there was nothing they could do to convince the doctors they were sane, and it quickly became clear that the only way out would be to agree that they were insane and then pretend to be getting better.
The only way out was to point out that they're correct. They had said I was insane, I am insane, but I'm getting better. That was an affirmation of their view of me.
When Rosenhan finally got out and reported the experiment, there was an uproar. He was accused of trickery and deceit. And one major hospital challenged him to send some more fakes to them, guaranteeing that they would spot them this time. Rosenhan agreed. And after a month, the hospital proudly announced that they had discovered 41 fakes. Rosenhan then revealed he had sent no one to the hospital.